Hi, I'm Rocco Steno, and welcome to a special Storymakers. It's special because we're going all the way to Glasgow, Scotland, to visit with the creators of Bluebeard. And that is Sandra Mars and John Chalmers. Welcome to Storymakers.
Hi, Rocco. It's good to be here.
Hi, Rocco. Thanks for having us on Storymakers.
Yes, we're delighted. You know, not only are we visiting Glasgow, but we're also visiting your home. And I see that you have a bookcase behind you, and I see copies of Bluebeard, but I also see copies of some other books. Are those other books that you created?
That's right. They're the fairy tale books that we created before Bluebeard for Papercuts. They're part of a trilogy of fairy tales. That's The Little Mermaid and The Red Shoes and Other Tales.
Yes. You know, it's interesting because it says Bluebeard and it has Meta Frog as the creator of the book. Who and what is Meta Frog?
Well, Meta Frog is me, Sandra Mars.
And me, myself, John Chalmers, and we've been making comics and graphic novels together for 25 years, over 25 years, in fact.
So that is the common name that we use to work together.
And right above the title, it says a feminist fairy tale. We're going to ask you why it's a feminist fairy tale in one moment. But before that, Bluebeard. Many people may know who Bluebeard is, but for those people that don't, who is Bluebeard, or what is Bluebeard?
Well, Bluebeard is an old French folktale or fairy tale, and it was originally written by Charles Perrault, and he is most famously known for Cinderella.
The character Bluebeard is quite fascinating because not only does he have a blue beard, but his name is sort of shrouded in mystery, if you like. Apparently he's been married, perhaps even married several times. Not only that, but his wives have also disappeared. So it's quite a thrilling story. I think a lot of folk tales are often quite thrilling because they're fairly dark, carry a strong message.
We have several versions of the story of Bluebeard, and yours is perhaps the latest version. And how have you adapted it for today's reader?
Well, we turned the story around a little bit. The story is not so much about Bluebeard. It's more about the strong female character that we called Eve. And it's really about how she grew up and how she came to meet this mysterious man called Bluebeard. So we've developed her whole background and her whole story, really.
Eve's world changes when she's forced to marry Bluebeard. She finds herself locked in a castle. And it's a difficult situation for her because she's used to living in her village with her friend Tom, who's a sort of sweetheart. So we've taken the story and tried to make it more feminist in the sense of meaning equality for men and for women.
A feminist fairy tale. That sounds intriguing. Tell us more about that.
Well, Rocco, traditionally fairy tales usually have princesses who marry Prince Charmings or are rescued by Prince Charmings. And we wanted to create a fairy tale that had a strong female protagonist. So it's feminist in that sense.
Really, the word feminist, we wanted it just to mean that the men and the women had an equal opportunity. It seemed strange that somebody would have to be rescued by a prince or rescued by their brothers. So we wanted to make a sort of more modern and also more personal version of the tale.
Also, in the original version of the tale, the moral was that if a young girl is overly curious, she will be severely punished. So that's really not a message that we wanted to bring in our own book. So our message was that of harmony between the genders and also love and kindness.
It's human nature to be curious. It's human nature to be curious. And we wanted people to understand that it was an okay thing to be.
Yes, we're all curious. And speaking of curiosity, in the story, she has two brothers, and they go off, and one becomes a musketeer, and the other one a dragoon. So what is a musketeer, and what's a dragoon?
Well, Rocco, a musketeer is an old-fashioned soldier who carried a musket, which is a kind of gun, and they were originally from China. Not long after the invention of gunpowder came the guns. And there were also musketeers in India, but they were very common in Europe in the 17th century. It was a very interesting thing to research because we could find out what kind of uniforms they wore. Dragoons is another really interesting word because a dragoon carried a gun called a dragon, which was a shorter gun. And they think the name dragoon just came from those guns, but no one's really sure. And they were also around in the 17th century. The musketeers stopped being in armies in about 1850, apparently.
I was especially impressed with your use of color in the book. Can you tell us a little bit how you decide what colors you use and when you use them?
Well, I wanted to make the book look magical because it's a fairy tale. And so I used really strong, bright colors. And I also used different colors to represent Eve's world and Bluebeard's world. So Eve's world is very happy. It's an idyllic village that she lives in. So I used kind of pink colors. And for Bluebeard's world, because he's very mysterious, very dark, and he's a bit of a villain as well, I used blue colors.
And some of the images in the book, like the castle and the town, did you model any of those on real life places in Scotland?
They're not from real life places in Scotland. They're from my imagination, but also from things that I love. So Bluebeard, for example, we wanted to make him a sort of Dracula kind of character because he's quite scary. So I imagined what the Castle of Dracula would look like. So that's what that was based on. And the village is really an invented idyllic village, a fairy tale village that I took from my imagination. I wanted it to look like a very harmonious place, and it's a place where people don't have much money, but they do a lot of mending and repairing.
Can you explain, there are some drawings that seem to glow, and how do you achieve that?
Well, I used very bright colors on top of very dark colors. So I built, I painted, if you like, digitally, but I applied first really dark colors and then I built shading layers and layers on top of each other of much brighter and lighter colors. And that sort of creates a glowing effect.
So tell us a little more about the story and about the main character, Eve.
Well, our version of Bluebeard really focuses on Eve. And she's got a lovely life with her family and with her childhood sweetheart, Tom. But when she's forced to marry Bluebeard, her life really changes. She can no longer just be with Tom, and she finds herself alone in Bluebeard's castle. And although she can write to Tom and write to her brothers every day, she really feels that something's wrong. And back in the village, Tom, he also has an instinct and feels that something's wrong. So he writes a note to Bluebeard, and he gives it to their little bird, to send to them. And that's when the story gets really exciting.
Oh. Look, what have we here?
Oh.
A note. And it says... Oh, actually, you know, we're not supposed to be revealing the ending, so no spoilers. Sorry.
Well, now you have our curiosity up. So, Sandra, could you give us a little help in drawing our own Bluebeard?
Sure. So I'm going to start with, actually, you have to guess what I'm drawing. It'll soon become very clear. Okay, so it's actually eyes and top of a hat. So once I've done the eyes, I do a crooked nose. Then I add eyelashes because I like to draw eyelashes. Then I draw a twirly mustache. Then the mouth, and he's kind of smiling because he's evil. And then I'm ready to draw the face around it. And then I can do the top of the hat now. So it's quite a wide hat. Then I'm ready to draw his hair. It's very curly. And once I've done this, I can do the cape. He's got a dark cape. And then the final details are the lines of the hair. I like to draw lines to suggest that he's got hair. And then we're done. We've got Bluebeard.
Oh, terrific. If you decide to draw Bluebeard at home, it would be so much fun to get to see your version of Bluebeard. So if you'd like to post it online, you could use the hashtag BluebeardMetaFrog. And that's MetaFrog, MetaFrog. It was so nice visiting with the two of you today. And hopefully someday we can meet in person.
That would be really nice. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for coming to visit us in Glasgow in Scotland. It's a lovely sunny day. And indeed, we do hope that we can one day meet you in person, perhaps when we come to New York.
So remember, until next time, read a book in any format.